On 7 June 1961, a witness took the witness stand. During the Second World War, he'd spent 2 years in Auschwitz, and now, 17 years later, he was going to testify, tell his story in the courtroom about the crimes during the Holocaust. But during the beginning of his story, he couldn't find his words, and he eventually collapsed on the ground. He was unable to testify at a later moment. Now, his breakdown demonstrates the difficulty of testifying in crimes dealing with mass atrocities. Crimes which involve many people are extremely traumatic and are usually dealt with many years after the crimes took place. Now, this may seem really remote in both time and space, but war crime trials were held here in Groningen as well, some years after the Second World War. And since 1995, on a daily basis, witnesses are testifying, telling their story of horrendous mass crimes in The Hague before international criminal courts and tribunals, only 2.5 hours away from this room. But if I can't bring you to The Hague, I will bring The Hague to you. Judges of the International Criminal Court, 10 eyes pointing your way and 10 ears to determine whether they can rely on the testimony as evidence. Sometimes the witnesses are able to finish their story or continue their story. Sometimes the accused testifies as well. So they offer a piece of a puzzle through their testimony, a puzzle which, together with all the other evidence, is able to build a puzzle of who, what, where, and when, to give us the picture to hold someone responsible. But they don't all share the same story. Testimony relies on memory and the understanding of events, which can be incomplete, change over time, or even be incorrect. In my PhD research, I focus on the testimonies, the puzzle pieces of both the witnesses and the accused, because these are the puzzle pieces that we use the most. I do this because sometimes they appear to be different from truth. They contradict and they challenge determining responsibility. I do this by looking at the journey of testimony before it enters the courtroom, in the courtroom, and how it's eventually dealt with by judges in the judgment. Now, this journey is incredibly important because this journey can determine to what extent we may build an incomplete puzzle, the wrong puzzle, or no puzzle at all. Thank you.